हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज 14th पार्ट ऑफ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ नंबर 3। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फैक्टर्स ऑफ अ कॉम्पोजिट नंबर, मीन्स फाइंडिंग नंबर ऑफ फैक्टर्स ऑफ अ कॉम्पोजिट नंबर एंड सम ऑफ फैक्टर्स ऑफ ए कॉम्पोजिट नंबर। ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ यूनिक प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन थ्योरम। Unique prime factorization theorem saying that any composite n can be written in the form of 2 power a into 3 power b into 5 power c and so on, where a comma b comma c are natural numbers. Or another words, I can say that any composite number n can be written as in the form of p1 power alpha 1, p2 into alpha 2, p3 into alpha 3, so on, where p1 comma p2 comma p3 are distinct prime numbers, are different prime numbers, are different prime numbers, are distinct prime numbers, different prime numbers, and alpha 1 comma alpha 2 comma so on are natural numbers. So this is called unique prime factorization theorem. Okay, here the unique prime factorization theorem, also known as fundamental theorem of arithmetic, concerned the prime factorization of integers. It says that every non-zero integer can be expressed as the product of prime numbers unique way. Already clearly explained. For example, 6 is there, 2 into 3. 6 can be written as product of prime numbers unique way, 2 into 3 or 3 into 2, that only. What is the meaning of uniqueness? Here, you can't write 6 as product of prime numbers other than prime numbers 2 into 3. Okay, example, 18 is given. 18, 2 9s are, 3 3s are, what I can say, 2 power 1 into 3 power 2. For example, 35 given, 35, 7 5s are, 5 into 7. Okay, 120 given, you want to find the prime factorization of 120. 2 60s are, 2 30s are, 2 15s are, 3 5s are, 2 cube into 3 into 5, 3 power 1 into 5. This is the prime factorization of 120. Okay. Yeah. Next theorem, very, very, very important one. Number of factors of a composite number n, when it is expressed in the form of p1 power alpha 1, p2 power alpha 2, so on, pk power alpha k, is nothing but alpha 1 plus 1 into alpha 2 plus 1 into alpha 3 plus 1 and so on, alpha k plus 1. Okay, if n is p1 power alpha 1 into p2 power alpha 2 into p3 for alpha 3, so on, pk power alpha k, where p1, p2, p3 and pk are distinct prime numbers, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha all natural numbers. Number of factors of n, number of factors of n are number. So the formula given by alpha 1 plus 1 into alpha 2 plus 1 into alpha 3 plus 1 and so on, alpha k plus 1. So I will explain through example. Nana, for example, 120 given, we want to find the number of factors. So what it's saying, that 2 cube 3 5, 2 cube into 3 power 1 into 5 power 1. According this formula, number of factors equal to 3 plus 1 into 1 plus 1 into 1 plus 1. See, exponent plus 1, this exponent plus 1, this exponent plus, product only number of factors, 3 plus 1 4, 1 plus 1 2, 1 plus 1 2, so 4 2 are 8, 16. There are 16 factors exist for 120. Same concept I want to explain through one example, Nana. Listen, all of you. Okay. For example, find the number of factors of 48. Yeah, I want to find the factors of 48. We have several methods to find the factors, Nana, factors of composite number. I want to use one of the method. 48 can be written as 1 into 48, means that 1 is a factor and 48 is the factor for 48. 2 into 24, I can write what the meaning of that. 2 is one factor and 24 also another factor for 48. 3 into 3 ones are 3, 16 are 3 is a factor and 16 is a factor. 4 into 12, 4 is a factor, 12 is a factor. 5 into, won't get now, 5 is not a factor of 48. 6, 8s are 48. 6 after 7 won't be 8. 8 into 6, again reverse you will get. That's why what I can say, I can write these are the factors of 48. I will write factors of 48 are 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 comma, 4 comma, 6 comma, 8 comma, 12 comma, 16 comma, 24 comma, 48. Number, in number how many? Number, these are the factors, okay, in number. Number of factors. Number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, by using formula, 48 can be written as, so already I did 48 prime factorization, 2 24s are, 2 12s are, 2 6s are, 2 3s are, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 power 4 into 3 power 1. According to the formula number of factors, according to the formula, this exponent plus 1 into this exponent plus 1. 5 into 2, that is equal to 10. According to the formula, you got 10. Practically, you got 10. So, now I will explain another method to find the factors, important method. Important method to find the number of factors and factors. Find factors of a number. Very, very, very important method. Using unique prime factorization method, you can find the factors. I will show you. 48 can be written as, what is that? 2 power 4 into 3 power 1. So, this is the method, another method to find the number of factors. So, what this method saying that 2 power 4 can be written as 2 power 0, plus 2 power 1, plus 2 power 2, plus 2 power 3, plus 2 power 4. Actually, 2 power 4 value is not equal to 1 plus 2 power 1, plus 2 power 2, plus 2 power 4, plus 2 power 3. Even though 2 power 4 can be written as 2 power 0, plus 2 power 1, plus 2 power 2, plus 2 power 3, plus 2 power 4, to find its factors. Okay, this is one of the method to find the factors. 3 power 1 can be written as 3 power 0 plus 3 power 1. 3 power 0 means directly I can say 1 only. So, 1 plus 3 power 1. After that, assume that here we have to algebraic expression, just like x plus y plus z, some plus k plus l, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 terms into another algebraic expression having 2 terms here. Here 5 terms are then 1. 2 power 1, 2, 3, 4 plus extra 1. So, 5 terms here, 2 terms. Just like an algebraic expression can contain here 5 terms, 2 terms. After multiplying these two algebraic expressions without simplification, you get 10 terms only. Here 5 terms, here 2 terms. After multiplying these two brackets without simplification, so the big expression will containing 10 terms only. What are those 10 terms? Means x into a plus x into b plus y into a plus y into b plus z into a, plus z into b, plus k into a, plus k into b, plus l into a, plus l into b. So, what I am trying to explain you, after multiplying these two algebraic expressions, you get big expression. This expression contains 10 terms without simplification. Like that. Actually, here, 1, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, they are numbers only. Feel that they are algebraic variables and assume that this is one algebraic expression containing 5 terms. These algebraics contain 2 terms, multiply them. 1 into 1, 1,
plus 1 into 3, 3, plus 2 into 1, 2, plus 2 into 3, 6, okay, 2 square into 1, 4, plus 2 square into 3, 12, plus 2 cube into 1, 8, plus 2 cube into that, it is a 24, plus 2 power 4 into 16, plus 48. So here interesting result is, students, after multiplying these two brackets, you got big expression. The expression containing here 10 terms, those are 1, 3, 2, 6, 4, 12, 8, 24, 16, 48. Those are only the factors of 48. Interesting step. Right? Those are only the factors of 48. Observe here. 1 is the factor of 48 only. 2 is the factor of 48 only. 3 is the factor of 48 only. 4 is the factor of 48 only. 6 is the factor of 48 only. 6 after 8 is the factor of 48 only. 12 is the factor of 48 only. 16 is the factor of 48 only. 24 is the factor of 48 only. 48 is the factor of 48. Other than this, no factor exists for 48. Means what happened? After multiplying these two brackets, you get a big expression. That expression contains how many terms? Those many factors exist for 48. And those are the factors of 48. So what I can say? This expression contains 10 terms, 10 factors. And what are the factors? These only the factors. Okay. What I can say here? Number of factors. Equal 10. Factors. What are the factors? 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 comma, 4 comma, 6 comma, 8 comma, 12 comma, 16 comma, 24 comma, 48. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. In this way, using this formula, I can write number of factors and total factors of a composite. Let's go through another example. For example, what I should take? 108 given. 108. I want 5 factors of 108. By using this method, second method, we need to write 108 as the fraction theorem. 254s are, 227s are, 39s are, 33s are. So, what I can say, 2 square into 3 cube. Okay. Now, I want to find factors by using another method, important method. 2 power 2 as 2 power 0 plus 2 power 1 plus 2 power 3 power 3 can be written as 3 power 0, sorry, no need to write 3 power 0, directly 1. 3 power 1 plus 3 power 2 plus 3 power 3. Okay, first bracket containing 3 terms, second bracket containing 4 terms. After multiplying these two brackets, you get 12 terms. So, what are the 12? I will write 1 plus 3 plus 9 plus 27 plus 2 into 1, 2 plus 6 plus 18 plus 27, 2s are 54 plus 4 plus 4 is 12 plus 4 9s are 36 plus 108. So, what I am trying to explain you people that finding factors of a composite number, this is another method. So, what I can say here, 1 is a factor. 3 is a factor, 9 is a factor, 27 is a factor, 8 is a factor, 6 is a factor, sorry, 2 is a factor, 6 is a factor, 18, 54, 4, 12, 36 and 108. So, these are the factors of 108, no other factor exists for 108. How many terms are there in this expression? 12 terms. What I can say, there are 12 factors exist for 108 and these are the factors. Number of factors of 108 equal to 12. What are the factors? I want to write 1 is a factor, 2 is a factor, 3 is a factor, 4 is a factor, 4 after 6 is a factor, 6 after 9, no other is getting, okay. 9 is a factor, 9 after 12 is a factor, 12 after 18 is a factor, 18 after what, 27 is a factor. Okay, 27 after what? 36 a factor. Okay, 108 is a factor. So totally 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1 is missing. What is that? 3, 4, 9, 12. 54 is missing. Okay, I will write that 54 also. 54, 108.
By using factors of 108. Okay. By using formula also, I will find an already explained formula. By using formula, number of factors equal to that. What is the exponent of 2 there? 2. That exponent 2 plus 1 into exponent of 3 is 3. 3 plus 3 plus 1. What happened? 3 into 4. So 3 was at 12. So number of factors of 108, 12. By using formula, we are getting 12. Practically also, you got 12. Okay. Observe here for 48. 2 power 4 can be written as 1 plus 2 power 1 plus 2 power 2 plus 2 power 3 plus 2 power 4. And 3 power 1 can be written as 1 plus 3 power 1. We want number of factors. After multiplying these two brackets, I got a number of factors of 10. Because first bracket is consisting of 5 terms. Second bracket consisting of 2 terms. So number of terms in first bracket 5 into number of terms in second bracket 2 gives the total number of terms in the resulting expression. That is nothing but number of factors of 48. So what I am trying to explain you now, first bracket containing 5 terms, second bracket containing 2 terms, 5 to the 10. So what I can say, 5 terms means 4 plus 1, 2 power 4 is, and 4 plus 1 terms in the first bracket, 3 power 1 means what, second bracket containing 1 plus 1. That's why, by using formula, what I can say, number of factors equal to 2 power 4, 4 plus 1 into 3 power 1, 1 plus 1. So that is 4 plus 1, 5. Okay. So 5 into 2, so gives 10. That is the number of factors of 48. Okay. So for 108 also, I will explain how to find the number of factors. So 2 power 2 means that bracket containing 3 terms. 3 power 3. Okay. 2 power 2 means exponent of 2 is 2. 2 plus 1 terms means that bracket containing 3 terms. Second bracket containing 3 plus 1, 4 times. 3 plus 1, 4 times. These 3 into 4 only, the number of factors are 12. That's why what I can say in that bracket, 2 plus 1 into 4 plus 1. Yeah, that is 3 plus 1, 4, 3 is 12. Now I'm finalizing, Nana. I'm finalizing. For example, n is a number which is in the form of 2 power a into 3 power b into 5 power c. For example, a number. Now I want to find number of factors of n. Number of factors of n. So n can be written as, according to our method, that is 2 power 0, that is 1 plus 2 power 1 plus 2 power so on plus 2 power a, bracket close. 3 power b means 3 power 0 plus 3 power 1 plus 3 power 2 so on plus 3 power b plus 5 power 0 means 1 plus 5 power 1 so on 5 power c. So observe, students, first bracket containing a plus 1 terms, second bracket, see a1, 2 power 1 to 2 power a terms, then after 1 is there extra, that a plus 1 terms. Second bracket containing b plus 1 terms, third bracket containing c plus 1. After multiplying these three brackets, what will get? You get big expression containing a plus 1 term into b plus 1 term into c plus 1 term. Those are the factors of n, no other factors exist. Indirectly, what I can say, number of factors of n, nothing but a plus 1 into b plus 1 into c plus 1. So that I will write now. Number of factors of n equal to a plus 1 into b plus 1 into c plus 1. Okay. So this is final. Okay, Rana. Okay, I am trying to explain 2 power a into 3 power b into 5 power c. Number of factors equal to 2 power a plus 1, 3 power b plus 1, 5 power c plus 1. A plus 1 into b plus 1 into c plus 1. Exponent of 2, exponent of 3, exponent of 4. Okay. Now, final conclusion regarding number of factors of composite number. For example, n is a composite number, can be written as p1 power alpha 1 into p2 power alpha 2, so on pk power alpha k. Okay, here p1, p2, so on pk are distant prime numbers, alpha 1, alpha 2 are natural numbers. So what I can write p1 power alpha 1 according to my method, 1 plus p1 square, so on plus p1 power alpha 1. P2 power alpha 2 can be written as 1 plus, p2 square plus, so on plus p2 power alpha 2, so on. Last one can be written as 1 plus, pk square plus, so on plus pk power alpha. Okay. So students, here I have n k brackets after multiplying the secret bit. So first bracket containing alpha 1 plus 1 terms, second bracket containing alpha 2 plus 1 terms, obviously third bracket last bracket containing alpha k plus 1 terms. After multiplying these three all brackets, k brackets, you get alpha plus 1 into alpha 2 plus 1 into, so on alpha k plus 1 terms. Those are the factors of n, no other factor exists. Then I can say that these are the number of factors of n. Okay. Okay, now I want to write conclusion and number of factors of n. Number of factors of n. Number of factors of n. Equal to alpha 1 plus 1 into alpha 2 plus 1 into, so on alpha k plus 1. So this is the formula, by using this formula you can find out. Okay, so number of factors of a composite number n. Okay. Now I want to find the sum of factors of 48. Sum of factors of 48. Sum. So, first bracket containing 5 terms. Second bracket containing 3 terms. After multiplying that, last bracket containing 10 terms. Those are the factors of 48. Their addition is nothing but sum of the factors of 48. Now I want to add logically. Yeah. So add these two into 50. Add these two. We'll get 20. Add these two, we'll get 30. Add these two, we'll get 20. So 3 plus 1, 4. Add that. So 4, 7, 10, 12, 124. What the meaning of that? Sum of factors of 48 equal to 124. So actually, after writing all the factors, you can add them. Logically, you can add now. That I will explain how to add logically. How you got 124, I will explain another manner. See this one. So the first bracket, this bracket containing 5 terms, second bracket containing 2 terms. Do one thing, Nana. Add all the terms in the first bracket. Okay, what is that? 2, 4, 4 plus 2 cube plus 2 square. Add them, 31 will get. Next, add the sum of terms in the second bracket. 3 plus 1, 4. So multiply these two. 31 into 4, what we are getting? 124. That also equal to 124 only. So instead of adding all the terms in the last result, just add sum of terms in the first bracket into sum of the terms in the second bracket. That also gives the sum of the factors of 48. Okay, the interesting thing now. Instead of adding all, sum of the terms in the first bracket into sum of the terms in the second bracket also gives the sum of the factors of given number. So I want to find the sum of factors of 108 also. So here three brackets are there here, Nana. First of all, three brackets are there for us. So after multiplying those two brackets, you got 12 terms. Those are the factors of 12. addition of the these all 12 terms is nothing but sum of the factors of 108. So logical, you want to find the summation. For example, the summation is A. So how we'll get A another way, that is important thing. Okay, so instead of adding all these terms, directly we get the summation. Just add the terms in this bracket, add the terms in this bracket and multiply them, what you will get, that is the sum of the factors of 108. So this first bracket, so containing how much, what is the summation, Anna? 7. Okay, 727 plus 30, 40. So second bracket containing 40 terms. So 40 into 7 what? 280. What I can say? After adding all of those terms, what we will get 280. So directly I am getting the summation as 280. Then what is conclusion? Sum of the factors of 108 is equal to 208. Okay, sum of terms of the first bracket into sum of the terms of second bracket gives the sum of the factors of 108. Now I want to finalize here also. Sum of the factors of n. N is given as 2 power a into 3 power b into 5 power c. Now I want to write it. Yeah, important. Sum of factors of n equal to 2 power a into 3 power b into 5 power c. Actually, 2 power a, how can you write, Nana? 1 plus 2 power 1 plus 2 power 2 plus 1, 2 power a. 2 power 3 power b as 1 plus 3 power 1, so on, plus 3 power b. Okay, so 1 plus 5 power c. So first bracket containing a plus 1 terms, second bracket containing b plus 1 terms, third bracket containing c plus 1 terms. After multiplying all these brackets, we will get a plus 1 into b plus c plus 1 terms. Sum of those terms only the number of factors. So logically I want to add, Nana. Just add sum of terms in the first bracket into sum of the terms of second bracket into sum of the terms of third bracket. Also give the sum of the factors. Okay. But how to add sum of the terms of first bracket? 1 plus 2 plus 2 square so on plus 2 for a. How to find their summation? So you need to use concept of geometric progression, because the terms are in geometric progression. Okay, already you know that about geometric progression concept. Okay, so I will write that, Nana. The terms are given a comma ar comma ar square comma so on ar power n minus, that has to be in geometric progression. I want to find their addition, a plus ar plus so on ar power n minus 1. Have the formula a into r power n minus 1, r power n minus 1 by r minus 1. By using this formula, you can find the sum of n terms of a geometric progression. Observe here, the terms are in geometric progression only, no? So with common term, first term a and common ratio is 2. That's why, what I can say, a into r power n minus 1 by r minus 1, here a stand for 1, r stand for 2. So number of terms a plus 1, that's why 1 into 2 power a plus 1 minus 1 by 2 minus 1. This gives the sum of the terms of the first bracket. Okay, I will write that. I will write formula a into r power n minus 1 by r minus 1. This formula for Sn in geometric progression. Okay. Now, sum of terms in first bracket equal to a into r power a plus 1 minus 1 by r minus 1 into a into r means here 3, Nana, 3 power b plus 1 minus 1 by 3 minus 1. Here a into r means 5, 5 power c plus 1 terms minus 1 by c minus. So finalizing, number of factors of this number n equal to sum of factors of n equal to 2 power a plus 1 minus 1 by 1 into 3 power b plus 1 minus 1 by 2 into 5 power c plus 1 minus 1 by 4. So this is the formula to find the sum of the factors of n. Yeah, now I am finalizing for this, Nana. If the number is of the form P1 power alpha 1 into P2 power alpha 2, so on, Pk power alpha k, how to find some of their factors? I will write sum of factors of n equal to P1 power alpha 1 into P2 into alpha 2 into, so on, Pk power alpha k. So after writing n as 1 plus P1 plus P2 so on P1 power alpha 1, 1 plus P2 plus P2 so on P2 power alpha 2 and so on, just want to add sum of terms of this bracket into sum of terms of that bracket and so on, use the sum of the factors. I can write sigma n and sum of the factors, sigma n equal to number of terms here, they are in GP, first term 1, common ratio P1. First term is 1 nana in that bracket, common ratio is P1. A into P1 power alpha 1 plus 1, number of terms alpha plus 1 minus 1 by ratio minus 1, that is P1 minus 1 into, yeah, 1 into P2 power alpha 2 plus minus 1 by P2 minus 1 into, so here as A1, so on A1, common ratio Pk, Pk power alpha k plus 1 minus 1 by alpha k pk minus 1.
Last, sum of the factors of n equal to p1 power alpha 1 plus 1 minus 1 by p1 minus 1 into p2 power alpha 2 plus 1 minus 1 by p2 minus 1 into, so on should write, so many brackets will be, so on, at last, pk power alpha k plus 1 minus 1 by pk minus 1. Okay, now I will apply the formula for 108 as well as 48 directly. So, I don't want to expand it directly, I want to find some of the factors. Okay, sum of factors of 48 directly, sigma 48 equal to A stand for 2 nana here, exponent is 4 here. What is the formula? 2 power number of term 4 plus 1. What this saying that, what this formula is saying that, nana P1 power alpha 1 plus 1 minus 1 by P1 minus 1 into P2 power alpha 2 plus 1 minus 1 by P2 minus 1, so on. In this way, I can remember this. So, what I can say here, number of sum of factors is equal to 2 power 4 plus 1 minus 1 by 2 minus 1 into 3 power 1 plus 1 minus 1 by 3 minus 1. That is 2 power 5 minus 1, sorry, 2 power 5 minus 1 by 1 into 3 square minus 1 by 2. Okay. So, 2 power 5, 32 minus 1, 31, 3 square 9, 9 minus 1, 8 by 2, 2 1s are, 2 4s are, so 124. Means by using this formula, directly you can find. Okay. So, here also. We want find sum of factors of 108. Actually, we got 280. I will show you. Okay. Sum of factors of 108 equal to base is 2 as it is. Exponent is 2, 2 plus 1 minus 1 by base minus 1. Here base is 3, 3 power, exponent is 3, 3 plus 1. Minus 1 by 3 minus 1. That is equal to 2 plus 1, 3 nana, 2 power 3, 8 minus 1, 7 by 1. 3 plus 1, 4, 3 power 4, 81 minus 1, 80 by 3 minus 1, 2. So, what I can say, 7 into 40 this one, that is equal to 208. So, by using this formula, directly you can find sum of the factors composite.
what I explained in this class. If a composite number is given, how to find number of factors and sum of factors. Okay.